Hi, good morning, everybody. It's your girl again, Benny. And I know it's been a while, but yes, I've been working. So, yes, I just thought to put out a few things because I've had people reach out to me. They've had certain questions about e-commerce, and I would like to clarify some myths because I think a lot of people have it wrong. They have a very, very wrong. Very wrong perception as to how this works. So, as pretty as it may sound, and we have like a ton of people who have like these beautifully painted courses telling you how you can make six figures in 6 months and all of that. Well, it's good to be ambitious. I mean, these people seem like they have the drive and experience. Some of them don't tell you how long it took for them to break even to that level. So I just the purpose of this video is to clarify some myths, right? So I'm going to start by saying the world is digital now more than ever. We've seen like, oh, okay, the world is, in a very difficult space, and everybody now truly understands the need for technology and how technology can influence your business, how you can support your business. People now understand how important is it. Like, there are many physical businesses that didn't put too much emphasis or try to develop their tech, and now you have people figuring ways how to transact without necessarily being there, even for the smallest transactions, right? And it's possible, it's possible. So e-commerce is taking a very, very great turn. People now understand what many experts have been saying for years. That aside, I would like to talk about the myths people have about e-commerce. So if you decide to go into e-com, you're not caught up in surprises, or people have promised you it will go this way and then it doesn't exactly go that way. I would like to say the number one thing, number one myth I would like to X out today is that e-commerce is simple. Trust me, it is not simple. You still need your research. Just like any business model, it has its own challenges, so you need to do your research, and you will fail sometimes. You would go for the wrong product, or you will find yourself in a place where marketing is a challenge. There are many things, it has its own kind of challenges. So you're not free of the fact that you're doing your business in a digital space online does not rid you of the problems that come with it. It has its own challenges. Targeted marketing, you know how difficult that shit is. Product development, also very difficult. Competition and growth, that there's a lot of competition with e-commerce. So just like every other business, you struggle to grow, you make your mistakes, and then yeah, you go through pretty much everything you go through with a normal business with e-commerce. It's not as pretty as people paint it out to be. The number two myth I would like to X out today, like, please, let's talk about this. It's low cost. Oh my goodness. It's not low cost. The startup might be low cost. Your online store might pretty much not cost you anything, as opposed to having like an office space or a store physically. But the thing is, a branded store has its own level of marketing and reach out. Like, I drive past somewhere and the branded store is in my face. I'm like, oh, this is what they do. Or I can easily just search, okay, what do these people do? They've already done like, let's say, 10% of their marketing. But online, you create your store, nobody's looking at it. You have to brand it and you have to put it out there. So where physical businesses have spent money or invested, or any marketing physical businesses have done to physically be in your face, your store online is lacking. So you have to then put money on digital marketing. Marketing your online store is not cheap. if you want your ads to constantly be in people's faces and for people to buy your idea, you have to spend good money on advertising and promotions, and that is what really drives your cost up. The number three myth I would like to debunk today is you do not require experience. Please don't let anybody. I see so many monetized courses, and trust me, I've fallen for it before. They tell you you don't need any experience, or you don't need so much information, just dive in. I didn't know anything about business and I went right in and I made 6 figures in 6 months, and no, please don't buy it. Business knowledge, you cannot replace information and your basic business knowledge with any shortcut. You have to take it upon yourself as a business owner. It is your responsibility to research and to acquire the necessary knowledge you need to implement your business, whether it's online or physical. You cannot escape it. Monetized courses all over the internet preaching these jargons are getting people into trouble. People are wasting thousands of dollars buying these motivational courses with very little or no information whatsoever as to how you should operate. And then people do it, they pay for it, and they're like, oh yeah, we're gonna do what this guy says because this is what he says, and he made 6 figures in 6 months. Please don't fall for it. Now if you see somebody doing it and it's public knowledge that they're doing it, you can, there's no harm in having a mentor. But if the figures are unrealistic and the promises are ambiguous, I advise you to look again. Just as much information as you would require to run a physical business, you require to run a business online. The e-commerce space is not so flexible. It's highly competitive and you have to put in the work. There are no shortcuts. Again, I'm not saying that you cannot model your business after someone else's own. As a matter of fact, that concept pretty much works in the real world, right? You find someone who has done exactly what you're looking to do and you try to model your business after theirs, which is not a bad thing. But there's the issue of the get rich quick, oh you don't need too much experience, oh this, that. It doesn't work that way. Number four myth I would like to debunk today is it has no risks, or the risks are minimal. Please, anybody who tells you that also is lying to you. We will start from the numerous risks, the most expensive ones that people hardly talk about. The number one risk of e-commerce is fraud, right? So you have your own business and you get orders from people and you're glad, right? People are buying into your products and you're doing good, but then you come across a very large order and that's supposed to be like a breakthrough for you. You deliver the product and soon there's a problem with the payment method and you have a problem with the bank, and before you know you lose a lot of money. So fraud is one thing that is happening with e-commerce. People don't talk about it, business owners do not talk about it, but it happens. That's why people are taking extra measures and protecting their business, you know, making sure their payment is confirmed and secure, using platforms that will protect your money before they go into business. But there's fraud on the business owner part. There's also competition. The competition is more than you think it is, you know. I mean, because internet is so cheap now, especially in the Western world, it's very easy for people to just get on their computers and try to, you know, pretty much just go out there. And so you have many products in the market, and even though they are inferior, so many below the standard products are actually out there, they're still competing in your space. So you have to take note of that. The number three one is product development. So for a physical business or a service, you need as much time to develop a product that you are going to monetize and sell on the e-commerce space. You need that same energy, that amount of time that you spend developing a physical product for a physical business for an e-commerce business. Why do I say this? That's why it's risky. We know the whole world depends on China for manufacturing because of the low cost of production, as opposed to, so people go there, the labor is cheap, so it's easy for you. But then again, product development matters. So like, if someone tells you, oh, I could do this, we could do this, we could produce this number of units, our MOQs are this, and this is the quality, it sounds beautiful. Like, Chinese people are great marketers. When you have your meetings with them, they will convince you. But please order samples if you can. Order samples. I got this advice from my friend, my childhood friend, who told me, order a sample and also put them on the spot. If you can afford it, pay for a quality assurance person to go and take a look at your product and test it. You have to make sure that the content aligns with what you agreed with them. So even if you're not there physically to produce, or you don't have your manufacturing space and you outsource it to these people in different parts of the world, do your QA. Do your QA. And make sure you do your due diligence. You have to know. But there's nothing wrong in taking the extra mile to make sure that what you're delivering is actually of good quality. It may cost you a lot in the beginning, but with time, your business reputation would be very, very good. People would attach that level of quality to your business name, as opposed to just selling inferior products and not doing your due diligence and all of that. The number five myth I'd like to debunk today is those online courses will help you scale so quickly and all of that. Now, I have nothing. I actually admire people who are able to monetize their knowledge. I wish I could. I would probably along the line learn. But I would let you know that you buy a course, you invest in a course, and take the information with a pinch of salt. So that person talking to you is talking to you from a different environment. So he has different influence, a different set of influences on his business. He's talking to you from a different demographic. And you might be maybe way older and you're thinking, oh, how did he scale so quickly? I can you apply the same principles and might not work for you. And then you're disappointed. Oh, I paid $1,500 for this course and now I can't scale. The information is pretty much useless. He might be in a different sector. He might be dealing with a different set of products. And you're taking the marketing strategies using pushing a different set of products and trying to apply it to your own. Then you're also taking information about the products that are doing very well and trying to implement, and before implementation, those trending products have done their time and there's a new set of trending products and you're like, oh, my mentor asked me to do this or to do that and now I can't scale because I have all these goods and I'm not able to sell, because trends in the e-commerce industry, trends change. They change in your face. They change overnight. Customer demand might change. There was a time people didn't put much thought to Clorox. Like, why would I sell Clorox on Amazon? And then something like COVID-19 happens and they're like, wow, I've had this Clorox at Amazon store for almost 4 months and I sold out in a day. Trends, believe me, trends, just like every other market, trends change overnight and there's nothing you can do about it. That's the risk you've decided to take as a business owner when you said, I'm going to invest. You can also have inventory problems. I know, yes, drop shipping is there. You're like, okay, minimize cost. But sometimes you really do want to have your own inventory, right? So you can still have inventory problems. For the previous reason I spoke about, telling you we have the same challenges and then telling you that trends change overnight. It's crazy. Trends just go up and down, up and down. They change overnight. And when you get information or you have a course that tells you do this or that, sell this product, and then it does not sell, it's because the market trends have simply changed and people have decided to face another direction. So leading to inventory problems, you have product stock at your Amazon warehouse, or product stock, you know, with you for your Shopify store, And that is why people came up with the idea of drop shipping. But I personally also do not believe in 100% drop shipping. I believe in ordering the product and seeing when you order the inventory, you go through your inventory. I believe in doing things very well. So you go through your inventory and look at what can be done better. That way you can study your product, what can be done better with it, and how you can improve that product. And if you feel like you need to tweak the brand here or there, you need to work on certain things, you go ahead and do it. But it has its own inventory issues as well, for the previous reasons I told you. So that being said, those are the six myths I'd like to debunk today. I gave you a list of them. I said that e-commerce is simple, that's false. That it's low cost, that's false. That you do not require experience and knowledge, well, that's false. Like every other business, when you go in without experience, you're bound to make mistakes that would cost you. So that you don't require experience or business knowledge or information, that's false. The number four is that e-commerce has many risks. Many people think it's low risk. No, it's not low risk. That's false. The number five one I'd like to I already spoke about rather is that online courses will help you scale pretty quickly, and that's false. And number six is that inventory problems do not exist with e-commerce. That's also false. Just like every other business, e-commerce has its own cons as well. Great, I love it. I opted for it, to be sincere, because I have a very demanding family life. So I said, okay, how can I balance the two? And balance for a very long time was a big problem for me till I was able to figure out how to scale. I always knew I wanted to be an entrepreneur. I didn't know how. E-commerce showed me a way where I could do this at the same time, have time for the rest of my family, you know. So I was able to build a business strategy that worked for me, that I still am learning to develop or to build on. I'm not gonna say I know it all at this point, but yes, e-commerce gave me that opportunity, but it does have its own cons, just like every other business. And entrepreneurship is good, it's nice, you're living your dream, you're working on that very thing that you love. But it's not pretty, just like the world paints it out to be. I listen to so many motivational speakers. I'm like, really? Well, how about just telling them the truth that they would need to fully apply themselves and probably lose so many hours of sleep to get to the point that they are? How about letting them know that it's not so pretty, but don't look for the pretty, look for the end result? Why not give them those things? Why tell them it's easy? You don't go about telling people that achieving such greatness is simple, and then they're misguided, you know. So you find many people can't endure through business. I had to learn that. I learned that from someone close to me. I had to learn that you have to endure for a business to persist. It has to You have to endure as the business owner. You endure a lot. You endure a lot of loss, a lot of slow growth, very sometimes exposure might even be a problem, you know. But entrepreneurship is not as pretty as many people paint it to be, but it is possible. And there's this feeling of satisfaction that comes from doing that which you love, regardless of the challenges you face. This is why I advise people to choose entrepreneurship, choose business, choose e-commerce. Does it work for you? Is it that which you love? If it's something you love, please by all means dive in, and don't forget to do your due diligence. I can't emphasize on that enough. It's important that you do your due diligence, or you'll find yourself in a situation where you're trying to, you know, how will I put it? You're struggling. And then again, as an e-commerce person, you must also learn to be able to switch, change. You must get used to change, because like I said, the markets change overnight, trends change, customers might face another direction overnight, and there's nothing you can do about it. So you have to get used to change, and you have to learn how to be decisive, act fast, so that you can scale with the trends, right? That being said, it's me again, Benny, and I. Stay safe, stay at home, use this time to reflect. At the same time, use this time to seek knowledge. Do your best. Tell those you love that you love them. And don't forget to hold on to those things that money definitely cannot buy while you're searching for your financial independence and all of that. Love from this side, Benny, and know that I love you. Enjoy your day. Enjoy the rest of your week. No, weekend actually. Oh my God, I've lost track of time so much that I don't even know what day it is. I just wake up and get to the day and go to bed. You know, sometimes I don't even look at dates. Wow. Oh, it's good to know that I've been busy, but I like it. So, like I said again, I love you and enjoy your day. Enjoy your weekend.